What is going on, you guys? Mr. LaPerre here, back again with another What If. So, what if Spider-Man lost the wrestling match? So, we go deeper into the story and we'll talk about some alternate changes and how this timeline would be effective if Spider-Man ended up losing the wrestling match in Spider-Man 1, where he ended up fighting Bonesaw and he won under the 2-minute mark. But what if this time events went differently? What if Peter actually didn't win the cage match? So anyways, let's find out. Here we go. Peter gets ready for the cage match as he knows he can't stop what is about to come. He still doesn't know what he got himself into. Like, he's like, okay, you know, I need the $3,000, but he's like, he still doesn't know what the heck's happening. And during the match, everything would be going as the same, just like the timeline, but this time Peter would be a second too late, and there would be a chair that would hit him in the face that would actually go over the 3-minute mark, because it was a 2-minute match. You know, you didn't pin him in $3,000. It was $3,000 for 3 minutes, and you pinned him in 2. So this time it actually was 4 minutes, and then after that they actually rang the bell and they actually were disqualified, and they actually gave the win to Bonesaw, and they pretty much screwed over Peter during this fight. And then Bonesaw ended up hitting him with the chair again, and then he gave him his hand to pick him back up after the fight, and he would tell Peter he fought well, but he still had much to learn if he wanted to become a full-time wrestler in the business. And Bonesaw would pretty much ask him, like, how the heck were you able to do all those stuff, like, in the ring? And Peter wouldn't really say too much about his spider powers. You know, he would just say that he didn't really know what he was doing, and he just, you know, he had fun while doing it. And that was pretty much it. So, you know, Bonesaw was trying to talk to Peter, and, like, he was actually a pretty nice person. You know, the fans really liked Bonesaw, and Peter and Bonesaw would walk up to the man who actually had the $3,000, and they would give it to Bonesaw, and they wouldn't give Peter anything. You know, they'd be like, well, you lost, you know, you, like, it was a time limit match, and you went over the time limit, so we had to disqualify you, so you don't even win anything. So Peter was pretty disappointed in that, but he didn't really say too much because, you know, he didn't even know what he got himself into. So Peter and Bonesaw would then leave the room, and as they were leaving the room, somebody came in with a gun demanding money. Now, you know, the thing with this is Peter and Bonesaw were halfway down the elevator. You know, they were, like, walking down where the elevator was, and then the man pretty much ran in asking for money. He demanded a bag of money. And Bonesaw and Peter were looking at, you know, like, what was going on here, and they didn't know what to do. And then the robber would hit the man in the face, and he would run out the door with no money. And then as he was looking, he would run to Bonesaw, and he would actually point the gun at Peter and Bonesaw, and Peter didn't even know what to do. So they would point the gun at him, and then what actually happened was, is Bonesaw didn't know what to do at all, so he actually gave the money up. And then, as this happened, Peter used his webs to take the gun out of his hand, and then he punched him right in the face, and, like, Dennis Carradine was pretty much done. Like, he was on the ground, and then Bonesaw picked him up and body slammed him right on the ground and gave him to the police. And the police, you know, were, they were like, what the heck are you doing? Like, you're not allowed to do that. And, like, the police handcuffed Dennis Carradine, and then Peter would be so happy because he felt, like, a sense of, like, relief of, like, what was going on. And, like, Bonesaw would be like, you know, like, you saved my life, because he could have got shot and killed. And Bonesaw would actually pick up the $3,000 from the robber that, you know, he took the $3,000, and then he would grab it off from the ground, and he would actually hand it to Peter and be like, you know, you helped me, actually, like, you know, you saved my life. So he would give the $3,000 to Peter, and, like, he'd be so happy. And then it would, events would play out so differently, because he would go outside and see another robber that was actually Flint Marko pointing a gun at Uncle Ben, and he didn't know what to do, and he didn't want to tell Uncle Ben that he was Spider-Man either. So Peter actually puts his mask back on, and he jumps right near the car, and as Uncle Ben had a gun to him, pretty much, Peter would put the mask on, and the guy would look at Spider-Man, and he would jump in the car, and he would drive off. And now events are playing out just as the other timeline is, except this time now we have Spider-Man chasing Flint Marko with Uncle Ben's car, and Spider-Man isn't really mad because, you know, Uncle Ben's not dead. So Uncle Ben lived during this timeline. So now we have Flint Marko in the car, and pretty much Peter goes up to Uncle Ben before he starts swinging. He's like, are you okay and stuff? And Uncle Ben says, yes, he's fine. And it's really interesting because he's like, because Uncle Ben actually does know that he's Spider-Man, but he doesn't say anything. So then he starts chasing down Flint Marko in the car, and he wouldn't be as angered because, you know, Uncle Ben finally lives. And then they would go to the same events as Spider-Man 1, where Dennis Carradine was, except this time it would be Flint Marko that would be there. And then he would say, "You stole my uncle's car and you were about to kill him." And then he would actually break his wrist, and then he would punch him in the face 2 times, knocking him out, and he would save him for the cops. And then he would web him up, and then he would actually swing away. So this time nobody actually died during this event, you know, nobody died, you know, Flint Marko lived, Dennis Carradine lived, Uncle Ben lived, and everybody would actually be still alive. So Peter would swing home as fast as he could to see if Uncle Ben was okay. And what happened was, is he still has the money, so, you know, Peter still has the $3,000. And he would say that he went to a wrestling match and that he actually bet on Bonesaw to win the match. And he said that he bet $3,000 that he didn't have. And then he said that he actually won the money from the wrestling match and how he was actually betting. So he pretty much lied to Aunt May and Uncle Ben. And they would be shocked at him, but they would tell Peter that Uncle Ben was robbed and that his car was pretty much stolen. And what actually happens is Peter looks outside to see the car, and it was all damaged and stuff, and a tow truck actually brought it back. So then Peter looks at the money that he's been given from, like, Bonesaw, and he's like, you know what? He's like, I gotta do the right thing here. And he hands Uncle Ben the $3,000 for a new vehicle, and, like, Uncle Ben would be really proud of him, and he would be really happy. And then after that, you know, Uncle Ben would know that he was Spider-Man because he could see the human spider suit underneath his hoodie. So, you know, he would already know that he was Spider-Man, but he didn't want to say anything. You know, he wanted to keep it quiet, and he was like there's gonna be great things for him in the future. And during the same night, Peter would be making his new Spider-Man suit, and as he was making it, Uncle Ben would actually open the door and walk in, and Peter would, like, look at Uncle Ben and try to explain, like, it's not me, I'm not Spider-Man. And then what actually happens is Uncle Ben walks up to Peter and he's like,
remember, great power comes great responsibility.
And then they would shake hands, and then Spider-Man was born. So that's part one to What If Spider-Man Lost the Wrestling Match. I don't know if I'm gonna get into part two. If we get 200 likes on this video, I will be making a part two. So anyways, how do you think part two is gonna go down if I end up making it? And I hope that you guys did enjoy this What If. You know, I wanted to keep it very interesting, and to see, like, what's going to happen next is going to be really cool, because now we have Dennis Carradine still alive, Flint Marko still alive, we have Uncle Ben still alive, we have everyone still alive in this universe, and now we have, you know, a way better Spider-Man than we had before, because now he's not depressed, he gave Uncle Ben $3,000, and, you know, he's just feeling like, you know, he's on top of the world right now. So anyways, what do you guys think about this What If? Do make sure to subscribe if you guys are new to the channel and if you guys are new to this series. And I hope that you guys enjoy and stay tuned for the next episode. But anyways, have a fantastic day as always.